Hello, welcome back to another video. Today we are playing I Love You, Colonel Sanders Dating Simulator Part 2. Apparently last time we got ourselves a game over. And which would mean that I did research that we got a bad ending. So now we're gonna try again, continue on, continue our adventure. So I guess we just press continue, I'm guessing. Let's go. Okay, so this is where we were at. Okay. Wow, the cafeteria is as nice you've ever... as nice as any restaurant you've ever eaten at. It makes sense that a school dedicated to cooking would also be serious about cooking. A delicious fragrance wafts through the room and tickles the end of your nose. Your mouth waters. So this is like the last part. Yeah, I remember this. Should I skip this? I think I should skip. No, I guess I'll read it. Do you smell that? Do you smell that? I'll do it in my regular voice. Then her voice. Do you smell that? That must be our lunch. It smells crazy good. Everyone can have your attention. Is it about lunch? No, I guess I'll do their voices. No, to apologize for my tardiness, you see, I was... Howdy, folks, I'd like to make an announcement. Hey, I was... It's about lunch. Everyone cheers. But I...
Lunch!
She said, shh. In honor our new semester, I have prepared something special to share with everyone for lunch.
Aha! That must be the smell I've smelled.
Indeed, that smell. You hold your breath, waiting to see what food this mysterious student has created. You've heard he's very talented. That was the rumor. True is true. This. Oh, it's the chicken bucket. Yeah. I know, we got to this scene last time. What? What, you think you want some stupid recipe, dude? So what? Nah, my dude, nah. I'm just drafting the taste of it. Let me give a new voice. Hold on. I'm gonna give him a new voice. He looks around nervously to see if anyone is laughing at his sick burn. You wait to see... See what Zinger Alice Ashley, or her name is Ashley. Ashley has prepared to follow up, but she suddenly takes a different approach.
Yeah, I was just writing in my diary. Today I smell something beautiful. I knew at that moment that only hands of a true gentleman could fry chicken so tender.
You see her body language change from bitter and evil to sweet and innocent as she slides closer to Colonel Sanders. She realizes that He is destined for greatness and fame. With cooking skills like this, she wants him all to herself. Like I said before,
go, Diggy.
Please.
Whoa, Fan Ven, the man. If you don't want any,
I'll take it. I'll take it.
Whoa,
hold on. I guess I'll try it.
Take one bite, and his eyes grow wide. He starts contorting his face as he tries to hold in his pure exhilaration.
It act unimpressed.
Easy now, there's enough for everyone. Please follow my classmates. Dig in, my fellow classmates, and not follow. You take one of the pieces of fried chicken out of his bucket and seek it into your teeth.
It's amazing!
Yup, this is a scene.
Tasting Colonel Sanders' food transports you to another dimension. Along to the taste buds, giving a drumstick in your hand, you float weightlessly. Let's not swim to the light like last time, so we didn't think about this. Save a moment and everything. Let me try this one, the first one. You let the food rest in your mouth and focus on it. Scrutinizing every flavor. Salt, maybe? Pepper? Too obvious. Oregano? Basil? Maybe, but there's something else. Something dark, something spicy. You dig deeper. Yes, even deeper still, until you find it. Could it be... I don't know what that it was. He really did it. How bold, how adventurous to use... What? Use what? You try to go even deeper into the sea of flavors, but this revelation alone is more than you can handle. You snap out of it and realize that this information was meant to remain a secret, and yet, now you know. A mantle of responsibility now rests upon your shoulders. Great, now you have responsibility. I gotta remember that. As you look around, you realize that everyone in the room is consumed by the lunch. No one noticed that you've traveled through space and time.
The heck? Wait, we can travel through space and time?
Hold on, then Trunks, I don't need your time machine. Crazy.
After tasting his food, you try to get some one-on-one with time with Colonel Sanders. I guess we gotta approach him.
You dare approach me?
Colonel Sanders smiles ever so softly as you approach this approach. He stops what he is doing and allows you to break the silence. Kono, I wonder if I could talk to you for a second? Anything for a fellow chef.
What exactly was on that chicken?
How bold to come out and ask.
Jesus Christ.
It's an idea I had. For a new combination of flavors that I will make me my fortune and establish my legacy for all time as I open a chain of highly successful fried chicken restaurants.
I'm stuck at reading!
No big deal.
It's just you and me here talking. I can keep a secret. In fact, I've got some of my own that I'd be willing to trade.
What's the rush? The semester is only getting started. We got two more whole days to get to know each other. He's clearly not going to give it up easily, but it doesn't hurt to be persistent.
You know what they say about secrets, Colonel? Shouldn't
learning be fun?
Aw.
You got moxie. I'll give you that. Colonel Sanders looks both ways to make sure that you're truly alone, and then leans in.
Hey!
You can feel his warm breath as he whispers. Ugh, I don't like the details. Don't tell me that. That's sus. Just one ingredient that I can't tell you I use. What is this? What does this mean? Is this Japanese? I need to learn. It's something my great-grandmother taught me.
Great-grandmother?
Wait, how old is Colonel Sanders then? If that's the case, then wouldn't his great-grandmother be dead? Then how old did his great-grandmother taught him? Like, is she still alive? Ugh, I don't want to know.
Blank, wow. You'd never have guessed
that. In fact, you're not even sure where you'd get something if you search. Okay, so maybe this blank thing, I feel like we have to, like, discover it. I don't know. You gotta look for clues, probably.
And blank definitely isn't the flavor you tasted before. So now you're
two ingredients closer to knowing the recipe. But you don't tell Colonel Sanders that. While you were wrapped up in that huge revelation, you notice that Colonel Sanders has disappeared while everyone else is still in the cafeteria. You decide to look for him.
Colonel Sanders, what you been doing,
You find Colonel Sanders outside standing in the quad.
Oh, it's you again. Howdy. Sometimes I like to come outside and look at the school buildings. I think about how my story will continue after I've graduated.
It sounds like you have big plans.
Yeah, I can see that.
I dare say the biggest.
I will leave my remark on this school. You bet on that.
Alone together, for the first time, you figure now is the perfect moment to show your personality to him. Nag him to know your own strength. Wow him with a big idea. Be modest but thoughtful.
Hey bro, I'm gonna show my own strength. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I've been thinking about your secret recipe.
Of course you were. You don't simply forget a flavor combination like that.
That's exactly right. Right, I remember it, but it's because I've tasted it before. I stopped at a random fried chicken stand the other day, and their chicken tasted exactly like yours.
Did you just compare my recipe to a random fried chicken stand?
Well, yes, I did, but it was a really good stand, especially considering it was frozen at first.
Frozen chicken?
Colonel Sanders struggles to conceal his emotions, fighting back tears of anger.
You were about to square up?
Yo, I think we might have to fight him, probably, or do something. I don't know. He seems angry. He seems pissed.
I can't believe you say such a thing.
You realize you've done incredible damage to your
relationship,
for which it can never recover. He hurts. He's hurt.
Ah!
How could you?
Hey, Akuta. You say that the game is called Dating Sim, right? It's that the idea of dating is this is not a game for you, not the game for you.
Oh, come on! We got another bad end. Oh my god. Ugh.
Try again.
Oh my god.
Bro, this game is doo-doo. I'm joking, it's not bad. It's just Ugh.
You just make the wrong choices, bro. So, you can't pick the bad ones. You can't pick the ones that sound bad. Can my game load? Is my game broken? Can I load? Now, let me go there. Let me go to second byte and let me catch up. To know where the whole, you know, the whole scene, because apparently it wasn't loading as much, so I had to, like, you know,
this time travel.
Come on. Come on, game. Come on. So how's everyone's day today? Going good? Mine's doing good, you know. You know, it's been alright, but wasn't the best. Oh, there we go. Alright, so we're gonna skip that. Skip, 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 skip. Skip. Skip.
Aha!
Skip, 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 skip. Okay, finally. Alright. So now we should do. I think we should do. Let's be a bit modest, you know what I'm saying? Be modest, be modest. Well, I just wanted to tell you that I really enjoyed your food. Now you got his attention. The flavors were complex, but comforting. The interplay became between salty, savory, and peppery. It was perfect. I appreciate the compliment, Akuta. I'm sure you'll be a big success. I know we've only met today, but I'm starting to get the same feeling about you. We should head back inside. The next lesson starts soon. Oh, a cooking? Whoa, hold on, what? You step in the massive cooking arena where the afternoon lesson will take place. Each student gets an oven and all the tools and ingredients they could need.
Look at this place. It's magnificent. Finally, we get to show our stuff.
What stuff?
Wait a second. Oh no, we have to show our stuff. What if I totally blow it?
You're not going to blow anything. Yo, pause.
Except maybe kisses to the crowd of fans. You're going
to earn your signature. Adorable tiny food creations. Welcome, students, to the cooking arena. Today's lesson, we'll be cooking with partners. Hurry up and pair it off. Naturally, Miriam looks to you, but you're unable to control yourself and pounce onto. No! No! Hey, Kono, can you tackle this lesson as a team? A team of two, would that be in you, if that wasn't clear? You want to be my partner?
Aw.
Sure, Akuta. I'll prepare our station. Without you as a partner, Miriam was left standing alone. Two students quickly take notice.
Hello, new partner.
Beep, boop, boop, bees, booze, bee, bop, boop.
Hmm.
Oh my. Two potential partners. I'm sorry, Dunderman. I don't know who to choose. It looks like you'll have to pick her. Friend duties can be a little awkward, but the price you pay for not being alone forever. Who do you ask to be Marianne's partner?
Okay, you know what? Let me do it to my boy Pop. You know, my homie Pop, you know what I'm saying?
Sorry, Clank, but I think Miriam will be partnering up with Pop today.
No!
Pop gives a big smile as he steps to the same station as Miriam, or Miri.
I'm a chef!
He holds a bubbly banana without peeling it and probably eats the entire thing. Oh, Jesus Christ.
It's disconcerting, but Miri is too kind to act this grossed out.
I love your enthusiasm, Pop.
She looks at you like, really, this kid? But it's too late to change your choice now.
I should've given her Clank.
Okay, ouch. Oh, God. Now it's time to focus on your cooking classwork.
I'm trying to get with Miri, not with Colonel.
All right, you two. For today's lesson, we're going to keep it simple. Pick a basic dish, divide it into steps. Oh, no chef is an island, but it takes two flints to make a fire. You get the idea? Which dish do you suggest your partner, Colonel Sanders?
Steak, easy enough. It's fancy, but don't need to cook it.
Using octopus to blow Colonel Sanders' mind. Your grandmother's mashed potatoes and gravy.
Hey, let's use my grandma's mashed potatoes and gravy. You know what I'm saying? Grandma must be cooking the mashed potatoes.
Let's do mashed potatoes. I've always been something of a down-home chef. I was thinking we could make something warm, inviting, comforting. Maybe mashed potatoes.
And gravy?
I couldn't imagine one without the other. Connor Sanders has a coy look at you, causing your whole face to go beet red, embarrassed. You quickly turn around.
No! I'm becoming sus! I'm straight! No! I'm becoming gay.
I'll get the potatoes.
No.
No, please, let me. Picking perfect produce is the passion of mine.
Looks like things are getting pretty fresh around here. Does someone have a crush on Colonel Sanders?
We're just cooking partners. Mind your own business.
I'm trying to get with Miri.
Sanders' heart is my business. You better keep your fingers off my
mouth. You think you call someone?
Ugh. Jeez, Van Van. Well, I over here crushing Akuta's dreams. You're supposed to be taking care of our classwork. That was the deal, remember?
Colonel Sanders turns arms. Peeled potatoes, he tosses them into boiling water and turns his attention to you, to your old quote-unquote friends.
Oh, howdy there, Ashley, Van Van. Are we working in a quartet instead of a duet now?
Actually, no. It looked like Akuta was struggling, so we offered to give him a hand. You know how it is. These young amateur chefs need a lot of mentoring.
I was going to say, Gora Sanders, I could also teach you a thing or two about fancy food. Maybe one day you might be able to get up to my level. Ha! Doubt it.
Don't be rude, Van Van. Personally, I have no doubts of whatsoever about Colonel Sanders' ability to contact creations worthy of admiration. After all, your fried chicken was quite spectacular. But
the colonel,
if you ask me, I might be a better partner for you than this thing that has supposed into your statue station. Don't you feel deep down that we pass complimentary shadows we fit together? Like a thigh and a drumstick. It just makes sense.
Nothing about this makes any sense. But one thing is clear, she's going to come for Colonel if you don't watch out.
Do I have to be sus?
Sire.
Ashley is really going at you hard. You need to ask for some backup here before things get ugly.
Turn out. Turn to Colonel Sanders, Hunks of Hunks. Miriam.
Yo, we gonna get Miri, bro. She's my best friend.
She turns to Miri and asks as soon as she finds her senses and looks back. This girl's friend in need radar in the second to none. She immediately comes running over.
Yeah, Miri. Miri, best girl. Let's go.
If somebody treating my friend, I will destroy them. I'll grab them.
Let me chill.
I actually think that Ashley and Van Van were just leaving.
Leaving you in the dust. Yes, I have this. My skills as a chef, perhaps. But stepping away from this competition, you're sorely mistaken.
Miri, you're a friend. But Akuta is my partner for today's activity.
You look for sprinkles and hope that he might step in, but he's nowhere to be found. Darn, those cute corgis at their short but stubby stature. You look down at your station and realize that in the tension of the moment, your hands have been cooking on autopilot. Distracted by the drama, you've already crushed the boiled potatoes into perfectly creamy mashed texture, but with plenty of butter and cream for flavor. It's as if your natural passion guided you through the steps you know so well while your attention was elsewhere.
I just want to do it.
I'm gonna send his hand. He's holding a beautiful white, coarsely engraved boat out which pours a smooth brown gravy, smothering your nearly finished potato dish.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Gravy flows down the mound of mashed potatoes. The results look spectacular. Granny would be very proud. Kona Sanders would spark out at you. You reach. Oh, frick, I almost clicked. Sorry. Your eyes lock. The moment is electric. Time stands still. If you love something, set it free. Together, you dig the ideal master would say. Utensil into the mashed potatoes. Utensil. Utensil into the mashed potatoes and lift a heaping sporkful up when you see Ashley with a sinister look. She's plotting against you to be with Colonel Sanders.
I don't care.
The mashed potatoes. And then, filled with rage, without thinking, you fling the sportful mashed potatoes right into Ashley's stupid, beautiful face.
Why am I doing this?
Man, something. Do something.
Scooping out a fingerful,
Ren tastes the dripping mashed potatoes and gravy and realizes that it is delicious. Horrified by this revelation, he slinks away. Will he ever be able to cook something with so much love and integrity?
Hold on right there, Akuta. We don't want to waste food in a room cooking arena. Colonel Sanders, I expect better for you. If you throw one more spoonful, you'll be prepared to eat it from wherever it lands.
Wow.
Can I have potatoes, babe?
Radovan rushed back over a covered dish in his hand. Mashed potatoes with gravy? Pathetic.
Mashed potatoes with gravy? Pathetic. I prepared a full meal based upon my specialty, braised tentacles of octopus in my silky salt water sauce, plated on a battle axe at foot by my supreme chef ancestors.
You've ignored me for too long. That ends now, and it's I who I will have the first. I have first blood, and you will all look on with. And why is this? Why is Van Ren fit? Oh, you're not gonna ask that.
The interrupting student Van Ren, and swipes a bite of his signature dish right off the plate.
No, don't. Something about this dish doesn't strike my nose quite right. I think the octopus was rushed and may turn in the process. The results could be toxic.
Too late, it has been eaten.
I think I left something in the oven.
I don't feel so good.
He turned to a ghost. He's Danny Phantom. It killed him. Everyone, step back. Take another bite. Don't take another bite. What the heck? Oh my god. When you look back at the plate, the rest of it is gone. You take the tip of the tentacle and playing slurp up in Pop's mouth. Pop winces in pain just for a moment, then also immediately back to his oblivious self.
Oopsie.
Tastes like poison.
He's gonna die. He's gonna die.
The entire class gathered into Pop's final moments. Shock has frozen the crowd. The whole crowd. They are as motionless as statues. The bell rings, disrupting the moment of the snapping everyone back to reality. It would appear that Pop's enthusiasm for trying new things, despite obvious danger, has inoculated him against poison of all kinds.
He has powers.
Crazy.
I'm not sure if the professors here make enough money. Hello? I just turned into a ghost. Get over here.
Seeing that you're shaking up by that really annoying student and all his nonsense, Colonel Sanders approaches you.
I'm sorry you had to go through that. Please, let me walk you home. What? Like, for real? Come on.
You follow Colonel Sanders out of the room. At night, the school building has taken another vibe entirely. It's dark, a moon, and more than, like, a little spooky. Colonel Sanders stands in the quad's neon glow and speaks softly.
Those mashed potatoes you made in class today.
Before you go on, I want you to know they're not a great representation
of my skills. I didn't realize I was making them.
They were amazing. Tasting them, it reminded me why I became so passionate about a food to begin with. Colonel Sanders is getting choked up. Cooking is obviously important to him. In a way you find inspiring. Now might be the perfect time to tell him you're developing feelings for him. Colonel Sanders? Yes, Akuta? There's something I need to tell you.
Aha! Put it right there. There's something I need to tell you first.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, thank you, Godfan. Man, I'ma go confess to Miri. Thank you very much. You see, I was just a boy. I had a dream one day. I would be the greatest chef in the world has ever seen. And every day since, I've been working toward that dream, day and night, never stopping, never resting, also lifting a lot of weights, like so many weights.
We should follow our dreams with all of our hearts, that our souls may grant them like wishes floating on a shooting star.
Hey, no, I, you, shut up. I'm the only one.